Hi, my name is Nima Heidari, and I'm going to talk to you about one of the cases that we discussed in our webinar. This is a 43-year-old man who fell off a mountainside some 40 meters a year ago and sustained a number of injuries: a right femoral fracture, L1 burst fracture, and also his proximal tibia on the left side was also broken. The femur and the spine were fixed. Unfortunately, the proximal tibia fracture was missed. Here we have a 3D print of the proximal tibia. The mechanism of injury was most likely a hyperextension and a varus, so that the medial part of the tibial plateau has broken. You can see the lateral side is in the normal position. The medial side has gone into varus and has actually sloped anteriorly. The slope of the tibial plateau is usually 10 degrees t'other way. The solutions for this gentleman need to be tailored to the problem that he has. The main problem that he has is that he finds standing very difficult because the knees is unstable. It goes into a recurvatum and a varus. He also has pain in his knee. The options that we have for treatment are to correct the deformity, which is a complex intra-articular osteotomy, or to replace his knee. We know from literature with tibial plateau fractures that restoration of alignment in the knee is actually the first step that we have to do. The articular surface is quite forgiving here. And in order to be able to correct this deformity, we need to analyze it and to try and bring back the medial side to match the lateral side. And this requires a trapezoidal shape bone graft to be placed once we have performed the osteotomy and held in place for us to restore the proximal tibial anatomy. The take-home message here is restoring anatomy, particularly in the young patient, is always the first option to consider before thinking about arthroplasty.